Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Morning. Morning.
As we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind us. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord,
have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son raised up the fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal inheritance. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever. Amen.
Amen.
It is the Lord who speaks. I am going to lure her and lead her out into the wilderness and speak to her heart. There she will respond to me as she did when she was young, as she did when she came out of the land of Egypt. When that day comes, it is the Lord who speaks. She will call me my husband. No longer will she call me my Baal. I will betroth you to myself forever, betroth you with integrity and justice, with tenderness and love. I will betroth you to myself with faithfulness, and you will come to know the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is kind and full of compassion.
The Lord is kind and full of compassion.
I will bless you day after day and praise your name forever. The Lord is great, highly to be praised. His greatness cannot be measured.
The Lord is kind and full of compassion.
Age to age shall proclaim your works, shall declare your mighty deeds, shall speak of your splendor and glory, tell the tale of your wonderful works.
The Lord is kind and full of compassion.
They will speak of your terrible deeds, recount your greatness and might. They will recall your abundant goodness. Age to age shall ring out your justice.
The Lord is kind and full of compassion.
The Lord is kind and full of compassion, slow to anger, abounding in love. How good is the Lord to all, compassionate to all his creatures.
The Lord is kind and full of compassion.
Alleluia, alleluia. Your words are spirit, Lord, and they are life. You have the message of eternal life.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus was speaking, up came one of the officials I touch his cloak, I shall be well again." Jesus turned around and saw her, and he said to her, "Courage, my daughter, your faith has restored you to health." And from that moment, the woman was well again. When Jesus reached the official's house and saw the flute players and crowd making a commotion, he said, "Get out of here. The little girl is not dead, she is asleep." And they laughed at him. But when the people had been turned out, he went inside and took the little girl by the hand, and she stood up. And the news spread around the countryside. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As we know, during the life of Jesus in the Holy Land, it was the Romans who had power and official rule, and they would have been the ones who would appoint the officials of various towns and areas. And when people would approach these officials, they would bow low in a display of contrition and a display of submission. And yet we hear something quite remarkable in today's gospel, that the official comes to Jesus, and it is he who bows low and shows the very visible sign of submission to the power and authority of Christ. But of course, the power and authority that Jesus would display was very different to the power and authority that the Romans and their officials would show. Their power and authority was meant to belittle those subjects whom they were in charge. Jesus' power and authority, however, was, as we hear in today's gospel, was full of kindness and compassion. And this official in today's gospel noticed that in Christ there is kindness and compassion, and, as he hoped, there would be the healing of his daughter. This turns out to be the case as Jesus raises the little girl and she stands up and lives. Whenever we come in the presence of the Lord, we bow low in submission to Christ, who is powerless and full of compassion.
So let's just turn to the Lord with our prayers and intercession. We pray for the Church, all of God's holy people, that we may all be aware of our God, who is full of kindness and compassion. Lord, hear our mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for our world and its many millions who are troubled by war and conflict, by poverty and climate change. We pray for people of good will that they may work earnestly for peace, for change, and for justice. Lord, hear our mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Pray for ourselves and our journeys of faith, that we may subdue ourselves in the presence of the Lord, but not out of fear, but out of love. Lord, hear our mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick in mind or body, that they may know always in the healing presence of Christ. Lord, hear our mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For those who have died and those whose anniversaries have occurred this time, that they may find God in the kingdom of heaven. Lord, hear our
mercy.
We ask for the prayers of Mary, Mother of Christ, as we pray to him. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
We make these and all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have the strength of it. Which earth is given into your hands and made, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become us spiritual joy.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven. Through Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be
with you. And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom we made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we enter.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holiness these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon the land of the Jewful, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have had us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and very critical thoughts the chant, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that through the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint John Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Save us, man, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, now, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Love of God,
you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Body of Body of Body of Body of Body of
Let's pray. Grant, we pray, Lord, having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ,
Amen.
Just a reminder, there's no evening mass tomorrow at 6 o'clock, mass on Wednesday with the mass of confirmation at 7 o'clock. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.